I'm going to be starting with Mozart's Sonata in B flat major. I played a couple of Mozart's two movement sonatas, but this is the first three movement sonata of his that I've learned. My mom wanted me to play this one because it's one of her favorites. After the concert, you're going to have to tell me if you agree. The last movement is unusual because it has a middle section in a totally different time signature before going back to the original theme. I hope you enjoy this sonata with all of its beautiful melodies.
Thank you. Thank you.
going to sing three songs. The first one is Heidenröslein by Schubert. It's a conversation between a boy and a rose. The boy wants to pluck the rose, but the rose wants to stay alive and says that if he plucks her, she'll teach him a lesson with her thorns. That's exactly what ends up happening. Then I'm going to sing Das Veilchen by Mozart. It's about a violet who's in love with a girl for some reason. He wants to be the most beautiful violet possible so the girl will notice him, but it doesn't work. The girl not only ignores him, she accidentally steps on him. However, the violet is very happy that her foot touched him as he dies. With these two sad endings about flowers losing their lives, you won't be surprised to learn that Goethe wrote the words to both Heidenröslein and Das Veilchen. My last song is Barbarina's aria from The Marriage of Figaro. It's a song about a maid losing either her key, a pin, a piece of jewelry, or some other small household item. The item in question is widely debated because the language has changed a lot since this piece was written in the late 1700s. Whatever the item may be, Barbarina is very stressed about losing it and worried that her boss will be mad at her. The song basically chronicles her looking for it in various places and being filled with woe. I hope you enjoy these delightful songs. I mean, I hope you'll be delighted by these slightly depressing songs.
Thank you.
Beethoven sonata for the first time. His music is still from the classical period, but it's much more dramatic than the music that came before him. One thing to notice about Sonata number 1 is that the second movement is a theme and variations. After the theme, the piano has the most important part in variation 1, the violin has the most important part in variation 2, and then they trade off for variations 3 and 4. Thanks again to you all for watching my recital.
Thank you.
actually doing an encore on this recital. Instead, I'm going to do a couple improvs for you all. The thing about these improvs, you guys can tell me what to improv about, whether it's a flower or an animal or a color or a feeling. Just raise your hand and shout something out. Nancy?
A frog.
A frog?
Yes.
All right. Here we are.
This was on animal, but first, how you feel when I take out the metronome in your lesson, and then how you feel when I put it away.
Okay, here we go.
Baseball bat?